guys, what's up?
Hey, how's it going?
It's great we're to be good. Here. It's good to have you in studio.
I
finally.
Love your energy.
You love my energy?
I love your energy.
I don't know, it's coffee. No, it's just coffee. I had coffee, man. Like, it's crazy, but it's for rockstars. Rockstars are supposed to be like, you know, like most people
hyper.
Use the
No, I love it. It's great
Thank
to be
you,
here.
Sir, hyper.
I know, it's just hyper. Too much sugar,
some
I think.
You know, it's always nice to be with rockers.
Yeah, rockers, they are awesome. Rockers are the coolest people, like, to hang around with. If you're feeling low, just call a rockstar or just hang out with them.
Absolutely.
And it catches on to everybody. Like, it lights up the room.
So viral.
The vibe, yeah.
All right. Awesome. So, guys, if you're just joining us, this is a Straight Line Connection. You know, towards the end of last year, I was asking him, like, why haven't you had them yet? Like, they're so cool. They need to come over. Let's go. Just chill, guys. Just chill. Let's wait for them to release another song. They'll be here. They'll be here. Just chill. So, you're finally here, and we're so excited. And I'm sure so many guys at home are excited, just as me. So, welcome to
Y254.
This is the premiere, the debut of you guys being here on Y254. It's good to have you in the studio. All right, so we'll just go ahead and start maybe with your names. You tell that the name of the band is Straight Line Connection, but we want to know you individually. Yes.
Well,
I know, right? We'll start with him. You introduce yourself and what you do for the band.
Sure, yeah. My name is Gunn. Mm-hmm. I'm the guitarist.
Gunn, like G-U-N.
Like G-U-N, simple.
Oh,
two
okay,
letters.
Cool.
I think that's your real name.
That's what people need to know. That's what matters.
Sorry.
Me, I'm Ruben.
Yeah.
I'm the bass player.
Mm-hmm.
Bass.
I always love basses. I told you before. Not like that. For some reason, like, my dad was in somehow, and he was like a bass guitarist, so like it's in the family, yeah. So whenever I see basses, I'm like, you and my dad should have hung out, you know. All right, so moving on.
Oh yeah, my name's Param, but from the start I've been called P-Man.
So I know P-Man.
That's what
like...
I go by in the band. That's my band name. And I'm the drummer for Straight Line.
Drummer.
Yeah.
Awesome. Like, good to have you guys in the studio. Maybe Bart, we just want to know. Maybe give us a little bit of a background about the band. So when was it formed, and by who, and how many guys are in the band?
Yeah, that's a good question. So it's just three of us for now. And
awesome.
We were formed around August 2017.
Oh, that's just the other day,
just
man.
We're very new.
Yeah, I was expecting like we started like, you know, 10 years back. But
and we were actually very lucky. We played the metal festival.
Yeah. Remember, you catch and raised. This is the first time I was with Amos. You know Amos?
Yeah.
Amos, and I was like, okay. Well, those guys just played.
Yeah,
and then you realized, I'm like, what? Where have they been?
Yeah.
I've never seen these guys. They're like, okay. Since Metanoia, because Metanoia was the first, like,
you say, like, Indian band and all, right?
Really cool. And then you just went, like, shh.
Yeah.
Never saw. And then the other thing was like, but actually, I was like, is Metanoia back? He's like, no, there's a whole different crew. They're called Straight Line. I'm like, I actually remember borrowing a bass guitar from one of you guys. Was it Straight Line?
Yeah.
The brown bass guitar.
We've gone through different bassists. Ruben's been with us for quite a while now. So.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Cool. Nice.
About a year now.
All right.
Ruben's
nice.
Been with us. Yeah.
Okay. So that is like 2 years.
One and a half years.
And they're making moves in the industry.
Actually, we're working on an album.
You're working on an album?
Yeah,
no, I was expecting like, okay, so we're working on an EP that will be.
I'm not naming names. Some bands, you know who I'm talking about. Some bands, my good friends. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Some bands have been here for over, I don't know.
A long time. But I feel like this is what we need right now, because we're talking about taking rock to mainstream, to making rock mainstream. And I feel like we need this kind of energy. Not just you come with one band, one song, and then people wonder, like, where did you go to? I feel like we need this. Like, we actually need this right now, because he's the activist. You know, I'm like, he's like, yes, 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 yes. Like, Yeah,
absolutely. And you know, like one of our missions is to bring, like you said, rock back to mainstream.
Yeah,
the rockers who are hiding somewhere.
Yeah,
we exist, or other bands exist.
Right,
some really good bands out there.
Yeah,
there. Right, but we cannot do that if they don't like release more music and videos. We need videos. Yeah, we need music. Yeah, yeah. So we're excited. You guys are. We'll have an album soon. All right, so I feel like that was a question ingekuja tukimaliza, but then now since it's here, that's cool. But maybe you tell us about Australian Connection. What's the origin of the name? Where did it come from?
I actually don't know.
You know, we went for about a month. Him and I were just sending each other messages of very different names, all sorts of names. We didn't know which one to use. And then after a lot of thinking, we're like, you know what, this one rings a bit.
Mm-hmm.
It has a certain ring to it. So we stuck with it. We wanted to change it in between, but we thought, you know, let's just stick with it and see how it goes.
And it has grown on fans.
No.
They're meeting Kumi. They're just like straight, you know, and they have a connection, but they're straight. You know? That could be. Alright, man, that's amazing though. Like just finding people who like share the same. Like you know, sometimes it's hard being sometimes you compromise just being with some people because it's like work. We need to get it done. But finding people who share the same goal as you and everything, I feel like that's magic,
that's
right?
True. Yeah.
Yeah.
I usually say that's Tamu.
He speaks that kind of Swahili. I know. But to that Tamu. Anyway, so how long have you guys known each other?
Just since the band formed, actually.
Oh, really?
Oh?
That's it.
No way! I know, right? I thought so we met in college, and then this one we met, like...
Actually, one of my cousins is a mutual friend.
Oh.
I was in a band before called Bass 2-4.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Bass 2-4!
Yeah.
Yeah, that was an interesting band.
Yeah, we were mostly doing covers.
Yeah.
We'd play at open mic nights.
Yeah, what I usually liked about the band is like they used to have two bassists.
Yeah, two bassists.
Yeah.
Two guitarists.
Yeah. And
four total string instruments.
Yeah, it was
so
interesting. And then the ladies, yeah.
Yeah.
But I like if you're there. I like the split because I think now you're in Straight Line. There's one who's playing with Rish.
Yeah.
She also plays. She plays guitar bass.
Yeah, Jessica.
She plays bass.
Yeah.
That's cool. Awesome.
I would love that. Can you teach me how to play bass? I want that. Like, playing bass. And you are a chick who plays bass. That is so badass. Like, you know, like, I play bass for Straight Line Connection. Oh, he teaches.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Sign me up, please. All right, so as much as it's rock music, so what can you say you guys call the genre of rock? What kind of rock, your style, actually?
I would say we're all over, we play rock, but also like hard rock, and we also kind of delve into alt metal as well.
Right.
So we're kind of all over the place, really.
Ah, nice. All right, so I'm just told, maybe we remind our fans real quick. The names are Ruben, P-Man, and Gun. Yes, so we have Gun. We have Ruben, and we have P-Man. Amazing. So you're telling us about the style of music. So
yeah, that's it. I mean, like, our first release, Fight and Reconcile, is more like hard rock / alt metal.
Mm-hmm.
Our second release, Text Walking, is, I would say, hard rock.
Yeah.
But we also have like slower rock songs that we're gonna release on our album.
Mm-hmm.
But we also like have heavier songs as well that we're gonna be releasing as well. So
we like that. He likes that. Our fans love that.
That's great.
And speaking of heavy, this one. Okay, sorry. Sorry for calling you out. But there's a T-shirt I saw somewhere. You are rocking, and it had something about pop. And you were like, he doesn't dig pop. Okay, I would say,
tell him what his name. Lawrence was suggesting that he doesn't feel pop.
Yeah, so he doesn't feel pop. So when he talked about heavy, I'm like, well, I'm with you on that one. But we still have pop stars who watch the show. So, no, like.
Are you talking the one that's on all over Instagram?
Yes. Yeah. Well, tell us about that. I didn't want to put you on the spotlight.
I know, it's a funny story. I was just in a t-shirt store.
Yeah.
and I saw that shirt, and it was like love at first sight. That's really it. I was like, I gotta get that shirt.
So guys, I know the guys at home are confused. They're like, what are you talking about? So if you wanna know what I'm talking about, just head over to Instagram at Y254 channel. Just look at the poster we have, and on Twitter as well. Look for him, the shirt he's rocking. Just read what is written all over that shirt. That's what you're talking about. No pun intended. Actually, no shade, actually. And look at on their Instagram at Straight Line Connection, right?
Yep.
Yeah, you'll find the same tea. Just read what you're talking about. Something about pop, yeah? That's a hint. That's a hint. All right, so Ruben, what can you say actually inspired you to pick up the guitar?
Yes.
Yeah.
I've been playing since I was like 8.
Mm-hmm. I know. That's the kind of deep stuff I was talking about. You know, I was like, I've played since I was 2.
So yeah, I started with acoustic guitar.
Mm-hmm.
I did a bit of piano.
Mm-hmm.
Then afterwards, I decided to play bass.
Oh, bass.
Yes, yes.
Right. Yeah. So he grew up. He's like, yo. So I just broke my voice, and I think it would be better if my instrument matches this. I'm just thinking. Anyway, but it's really dope. So, the first song you released, your first single, "Fight and Reconcile." I want to know about that. Piman, you want to tell us about that?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. How did it come about?
So basically,
yeah.
He's the mastermind of all the lyrics and everything. And
nice.
The song basically revolves around this idea that, you know, we're gonna always face conflict,
yeah,
but at the end we always come to a resolution, you know.
Right.
So why fight when you're gonna reconcile? Just let things go and move forward with life.
Right.
There's no reason to fight.
So you fight and
you reconcile. It's just an endless loop. So why not avoid the conflict, you know, in the start?
All right. So maybe Gun can tell us more about that, since you're the one behind the lyrics. What were you going through at that particular moment?
I don't, you know, to be honest, it just comes to me. It's like, I think there's a reservoir of stuff in here. And it's
so you're one of those people that always walk around with a notebook and a pen. You're like,
not really. It's just it's just in the head. And when I write music on the guitar or whatever, and then the lyrics just come out. So this song, it has a heavy riff.
Mm-hmm.
And with that riff, I was just playing it over and over, and it just came to me, fight and reconcile, and then I built the whole song around that.
Uh-huh.
And so the song starts off, round and round in circles we go, where's the elusive straight line?
Right.
So we're always in a, like Param was saying, we're always in a circle of fight and reconcile, but there's, you know, where's the straight line?
Does that happen to you guys? Like, I know some people in the band that binds is like a family, like you always fight with your little brother and sister, and then you're still family. So does that happen to you guys? Do you have some disagreements, and at the end of the day you like sort it out? Yeah, Ruben, tell us.
We have disagreements, but not fights. I don't think we've gotten to a part where it's that serious.
Yeah,
we can disagree on different things,
right?
Yeah. And then
so
afterwards we are bros, so
you hang out and just like
we try not to escalate anything, you know. We talk it out.
Cool.
Like,
but we need you guys to stay together, like, please. Good music is good. We want good music to stay. So please, when you fight, just reconcile.
Yes.
Remember, when you're having in the heated argument, when you're just arguing, remember your first single. You're like, oh, we fight and reconcile. We don't do that here. We don't walk out. We fight and reconcile.
Yeah, exactly. You know,
right.
Just to add to that, I mean, to be honest, I think we get along very well.
Yeah.
And in fact, that question was interesting and funny, because I was trying to think, when have we ever fought? We've actually never fought. So it's one of those things.
You're like, nope, can't relate.
That's why I gave it to Ruben.
All right, so how was the song received? Because we played it, actually we featured you guys on Play to Trash It. Yes, the segment you just had.
Oh, you did, okay.
Yeah, we featured you when the song was very fresh. We featured you on that, and you came in second. You didn't get the first place, but yeah, you stayed.
We'll stay.
Yeah, I know, you're pretty new. People are always scared of the new guys. They're like, oh, who are they? Let's see how they're gonna do. But how has the reception been? How have people taken the song, the fans, the reception on social media, even where you've performed? How was the reception?
I think, you know, it's amazing, like the fans, like in Nairobi, and you know, we've been received very well as a band and as a song. And whenever we play the song live, we always have that kind of energy coming from the from the fans.
Yeah.
Our last show at Crooked Q was like, I just saw like a people
so
just
so many people, and they were moshing. They were
moshing.
Yeah.
It was so cool to see that.
Yeah. But like, how does that make you feel? Seeing people jamming and just moshing to your song, and you're like, oh,
you know
it's live.
That's what it's about for me anyway. That's exactly that. Mm-hmm. When I see the fans giving back to us, that's what it's about.
Yeah.
And you feel like putting more into it.
Yeah, you guys.
You know, it's they give you the energy to keep going.
To keep playing. Yeah, to keep even when like you're playing the guitar, like for you, like your fingers can't take it anymore. But you look at them and you're like, no, we can't stop now.
Yeah.
Does it ever get to that? Like your fingers are like, maybe you hurt yourself and you have to keep playing just because the fans are liking it or something?
It's not happened to me on stage, but I've had like an accident whereby I cut my finger. Then I have to not play with this finger for like a couple days.
That's awful. Yeah. Like,
yes,
I know.
But not on stage.
Yeah. Well, it's gonna happen, but you'll have to keep going. not that I wish that for that to happen. It happens, right? It's rock. It's rock music. But we like that. Anyway, so who can you say have been your influences in the industry?
For me personally, it's been I'm a big fan of Tool. Big fan of Tool. Rage Against the Machine. And then you have Metallica, Megadeth, Lamb
of God. Yeah, Metallica, obviously.
You know, Rage Against the Machine has a Kenyan in it, yeah?
Yes, I know, Tom Morello.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely.
He's called Kimani also. Tom Morello Kimani. He's our president's cousin. Seriously, and he's one of his favorites. Actually, I was reading it, and I got a chance to talk to somebody who's worked with him. That is Eric Wenaina. And I was like, he's somebody. They've done a tour with him sometime back in 2004, and it was big for Eric. So I like it when I hear some guys like such people.
We should try and get him back to Kenya.
I'm working on that. Trust me, I'm really working on that.
He's so cool.
He's a really cool guy, and he's really supportive. So, pole.
Those are my influences, and then I think Param has it.
Yeah, Pima.
I mean, for me, I've grown up on classic rock. Because my dad, I mean, he used to be in a band in his school and college days. So for me, it's been mostly like Pink Floyd, Led Zeppelin, Deep Purple.
I like Pink Floyd.
You know,
and we have a fan of the show who's like crazy about Pink Floyd.
I'm also a huge fan.
Yeah.
Massive fan, yeah.
Ruben.
Yeah, for me, I like it smooth. I listen to like Radiohead. Kind of.
I know, right?
Yeah.
But that's dope. But we want to know about your what are your rehearsals like, and how many times a week do you guys get to rehearse?
We try and do it once a week.
Once a week.
And consistently. And the good thing is, like, you know, we keep time as much as possible.
Yeah.
So a lot of metalheads and rockers show up late.
I know. Time.
Yeah, it's true. In fact, one of my friends, we were in a rehearsal, and he's like, and he also is in plays the guitar, and he's like, dude, you guys are the like first metal band I know that always keeps time.
Yeah, in Kenya, as in you keep time. But you know, never talk about that topic because that's just obvious. Like,
we try.
Yeah, that's cool. No one gets a straighter. It's always a straighter line of this thing.
It's a straight line.
We have to walk it.
That discipline needs to be there.
Yeah.
That discipline needs to be there.
True. That's right. That's right.
I feel like that's a requirement for any band.
I hope bands are listening to such stuff.
They have to.
You know, as long as you all meet, you can do whatever you want during the practice. Have your fun. Do whatever.
As long as you're there.
As long as you're there, just show up.
Just show up.
If you're not feeling that energetic,
just show up.
Show up, play what you can.
Yeah, and then
it's helpful.
We'll take care of the rest.
Like,
there's an incident. I've had that. Right?
Well, last week I was so pissed off at Ruben. I was so pissed off at him.
I'm so tired.
Oh, you're tired.
Yeah, I was so tired. I was so tired. So
I showed up like an hour late.
Some R&B, some blues, dude.
But in his defense, he was not
feeling well, so.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All right, cool. So I want you guys to tell us, what's the direction you want your music to take? Like, how do you want to shape your career in this, since you're just getting started? What direction do you guys want to take?
You know, I think that's, firstly, we want to release a couple more albums, so we're working on our first one.
Yeah, we're all about that.
And
yes,
we're going
please.
We're going to work on our second one. Hopefully, we can release it next year. And then we want to also try and build up the rock scene, like you were saying. I think the whole thing is the people out there who want to listen to rock and metal, but they don't know where to go.
Right.
So we are doing a monthly rock down show at
Crooked
Q.
Yes, I saw that.
Yeah, first, but it's not going to be just us. Mm-hmm. I'm one of the organizers, but it's not just going to be us. We want to get everyone a chance. Mm-hmm. And all the bands that we've spoken to are on board.
Awesome.
So that's another thing. I think once we grow the rock scene here, I think we have a major opportunity to have Nairobi become a hub.
Right, that's true. And I saw that you have a show coming up on the 2nd, and you have a show coming up on the 9th at Carnival. That's going to be...
We are just playing on the 2nd.
On the 2nd.
Feb 9th, no, that's not us.
Oh, that's not you, okay.
We are going to be probably playing with Rash in April or May or so.
Oh, dope.
So, yeah.
So tell us about the one that is coming up on 2nd of February. Tell us about that.
Oh, it's going to be mayhem. It's going to be beastly.
Yes, please. I hope the guys at home can actually hear. You actually can see this. If you want to know how to get the tickets, please follow them at Straightline Connection. They have all their posters and everything you need to know about that performance, where you can purchase this ticket, where the event is going to be. Just head over there, Straightline Connection, right?
Absolutely.
And on Twitter at Straightline Con, because I remember before I got that one, it took me a minute to get them on Twitter. So now on Twitter it's not Connection, it's actually Straightline Con. Make sure you interact with them. They can DM you, right?
Absolutely.
And the merchandise we are rocking, the t-shirts, and all about that. Tell the guys, where can they find them?
Yeah, I mean, just follow us on Twitter, Straightline Con, Instagram and Facebook, Straightline Connection, and just DM us, and we'll take it from there. 1,000 bob a shirt,
right?
And it's a really good price for now. We just want to promote. You know, really, that's it.
So, and they come in three colors: black, olive green, and red.
Wow. Yeah, can they get custom made? Like, if I want another color, can it be custom made?
At this point, I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
At this point, I don't think so, but maybe in the future we'll look at different colors. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, cool. But we still like it. This is like green, we have orange, we have black. So, yeah, I love the colors.
Wow.
Yeah. No reason to complain. All right, you guys have because my producer is telling me like we're almost out of time, so we just need to know about the single you just released. Tell us about that before we take a break, because we'll be taking a break soon. So yeah.
Sure, it's called Text Walking. Mm-hmm. It's again about, like, we write about philosophical stuff a lot, so Fighting Reconcile was one of them, Text Walking is another one. But we also write about personal stuff as well. But so Text Walking is about, you know, how we are just walking through a life, literally and figuratively.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so phones, yeah, that makes
walking,
sense.
But we also, like, in our minds, there's so much choice around us and all those kind of things, so we don't know which way we're going.
So Text Walking is like, you know how you're on your phone, and you can't see
there.
Where you're headed.
You're glued on your phone. You don't see what's around you.
All right.
You know, there's so much more around you.
Yeah, you don't get to see.
You don't get to experience all
you're
that.
Just on
because you're just stuck.
Your focus is on one thing.
Your focus is on one thing, yeah.
Oh, all right. Makes
and it's
sense.
Also to prove that we're against text walking.
Yeah. I don't like it.
Put your phone away.
What? Plug
in your earphones, listen to something, but don't be...
look around and smell the roses.
Yeah.
Or the coffee.
Yes. All right, so we want to... one thing, what should people expect from you moving forward? And then we'll be taking a short break. But before that, what should your fans expect from you? And just a quick reminder of your social media handles, and then we take that break.
Yeah, I mean, for us, just expect us to be here for a while. I mean, we're gonna keep on writing.
Yes, please stay. welcome you to stay.
We're gonna be doing, like, even acoustic sets. We're gonna be working very hard this year.
Yeah.
So yeah, and Again, our Twitter and Facebook is Straight Line Connection.
Mm-hmm.
And then, sorry, Twitter is Straight Line Con. Instagram and Facebook are Straight Line Connection.
Straight Line Connection. Awesome. That's amazing. We absolutely love that. And we love you guys for coming through on in the studio.
So nice
we did
you.
This. Thank you so much for coming. And we want you, next time you're coming, you have to play for us. Like, bring all
sure.
the instruments and
absolutely.
Everything.
Absolutely. That's what
yes?
we're doing.
Can you please do that for us?
For
definitely.
Sure.
Yeah.
We might just show up and just hang out with you guys.
Yes.
Whatever.
Always. Even
sometimes.
Next week. Do that. Do that.
That can be really cool.
Yeah. You're more than welcome to do that. Anytime
cool.
you feel like you want to come through, do come through.
Cool.
We can even host together. You can even DJ
yeah,
if you know
cool.
how to
yeah.
play. Yeah. All right. So much. Thank you so much, guys. And the guys at home, please stay with us. We'll be right back after this short break. We'll stay here. Keep it white to 54 channel. We'll have more for you.